Now let's just listen to this conversation between two friends. The first friend, blue friend, says that the average power consumed in an inductor and a capacitor is zero. Now, does this mean that if I'm using a device that has a motor, which means which has a large value of L or inductance in it, then am I using it free or do I have to pay any money to the power company? Now, red has absolutely no clue how to answer that question, that if the average power in an inductor and capacitor is zero, then do I have to pay to use them? Now, to be able to answer that question, we'll first take a look at what is average power, why is the power consumed in an inductor and a capacitor zero, and finally answer the question that do we need to pay our power company for using inductors and capacitors. Let's quickly recall a couple of things about an LCR circuit, something that we've already learned earlier. And in case you're not familiar with an LCR circuit, I suggest you first go through the lesson titled LCR in series and then come back to this chapter. Now, say a voltage V, which is given by Vm sin omega t, which is an alternating voltage, is applied to this LCR circuit. Now, the current I in this case is written as Im sin omega t plus phi, where if you recall, Vm is the voltage amplitude and over here Im is the current amplitude, omega is the angular frequency and phi is the phase. Now, the current amplitude is related to the voltage amplitude as Im equals Vm over Z, and Z is the impedance of the circuit, which for an LCR circuit is given by XL minus XC whole square plus R square. And the phase constant phi, we have tan phi equals XL minus XC over R. And you can find phi from this. So phi will be tan inverse XL minus XC over R. Now, these are a few formulae which we've learnt earlier. I haven't derived the formula over here. I'm just stating the formulae here. And now we are going to use these formulae further to talk about power. Now, if you recall, power is the product of voltage and current. So, power is equal to V times I. Now, we just wrote the expression for V as Vm sin omega t and I as Im sin omega t plus phi. So, we can write the power consumed in an AC circuit, in an LCR circuit, as V times I, which is equal to Vm Im sin omega t times sin omega t plus phi. Now, you know that since this value of V and I are the instantaneous value of voltage and current, so this expression for power is also the instantaneous power, which means the power consumed at each instant of the circuit. If you substitute the value of t over here, you get the value of power which is consumed at that point of time. See, if I just put these three quantities, the voltage, the current and the power, on a graph, you can see the variation. Let's say we take V. Since this is a sine curve, it starts from zero and this is the voltage, the variation of the voltage with respect to time, and we have a sine curve. Now, this is the graph for V, the voltage, and let's say we plot the current, and I'm assuming that it's a cos curve, so it starts from 1, and when this is maximum, it's going to be 0. So, and let's say this is the graph for the current, where I've assumed that there is a phase difference of 90 degrees. So I've just assumed phi to be 90. Now, if you take a look at the power, then since power is a product of V and I, so if either of them is 0, that means power is going to be 0. So at this instant, power is 0. At this instant, it is 0. At this instant, again, it is 0. Here it's going to be 0, and here once again it's going to be 0. So you can see in one full cycle of the voltage, you will get two cycles of the power. The frequency of power is going to be twice. Okay, now if we just draw the graph, in this case, since both are positive, so power is positive, and we get a graph which looks like this. In this range, one quantity is positive, V is positive, and I is negative, which means that power will be negative. Again, during this interval, say I call this 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Now between 3 and 4, you can see that both V and I both are negative. So the product is going to be positive. So again, we get a positive part in the graph. And in this and between 4 and 5, one quantity is positive and the other is negative. So we get a graph like this. Now this is a graph for the power P, and the graph over here shows the instantaneous value of power. Now over here we took phi equal to plus 90. So this was a case where the current was leading the voltage, which means it's an example of a capacitor. So you can see during the first quarter cycle, energy is stored in the electric field of the capacitor. On the next quarter cycle, the capacitor discharges and the energy is returned back to the generator. So the average over a full cycle is 0, because it is as much positive as it is negative. Using a similar graph, you can show that the average power in the inductor will also be 0. The only difference is, in that case, the energy is stored in the magnetic field. Now we are going to look at something which is called the average power, and which is an important quantity for us. Okay, now I want you to be ready for a lot of mathematical steps. The power P is equal to Vm sin omega t times Im sin omega t plus phi. Now we need to find the average value of power. So to find out the average value of power, we find out, so we'll use the trigonometric identity. 2 sin A sin B is equal to cos A minus B minus cos A plus B. So we use this trigonometric identity and we write power as Vm Im, and if you look at we combine these two terms together and write this as cos phi minus cos 2 omega t plus phi, where we've taken omega t as A and omega t plus phi as B, and put this into this formula. So what we are looking at is the average power, and which means the average of this entire term that we've got over here. Now what we need is the average of the first term, and the first term would mean Vm Im cos phi minus the average of the second term, which is cosine 2 omega t plus phi. So this term you can see is a constant, because Vm is a constant, Im is a constant, and the phase phi is a constant value. So the average of this term will be Vm Im cos phi, and the average of the second term, since this is a cos theta type of a term, the average of this term will turn out to be 0. See, you can show this using a graph. say we draw a graph for a cos function, you get a graph which looks like this, and this would be time 0, and this again is time t. This is a full time period. Now over a full time period, you can see that the graph has a positive value. The area, you can see that the area under the graph, which is positive and which is negative, are equal. So the average value of a cos theta term is also, just as a sin theta term, is 0. So we finally get the average power P equals Vm. Let me just write this once again. We had Vm Im cos phi, and splitting 2, we can write this as over root 2 times Im over root 2 times cos phi, so which finally gives us V RMS times I RMS times cos phi. And in case you're not familiar with RMS values, please go through the lesson titled RMS values, and once you've done that, then you can come back to this lesson. Okay, now for a resistive circuit, you know that phi, for a resistive circuit, you know that phi is 0, which means cos phi is 1, and the average power works out to be V RMS times I RMS. For an inductive circuit, you know that phi is equal to 90 degrees because the voltage across the inductor leads the current by 90. So if phi is 90, which means cos phi is 0, and which automatically gives us that the average power is 0 in case of an inductor. For a capacitive circuit, phi is, you have a negative sign because the voltage across the capacitor lags the current by 90 degrees. So cos phi is 0, which gives us the average power as 0. So that means we've answered two of the points which we raised at the beginning of the lesson. One is, what is average power? And you can see that average power is V RMS, I RMS times cos phi. And the other is that the average power in case of an inductor and a capacitor is 0. Now, what about this little additional term which is cos phi over here? See, this is not really a little term. This is an extremely important term. And this term is called the power factor. Let's take a look at the power factor, which is cos phi. See, if the voltage, let's say the voltage leads the current, say this is the current and this is the voltage in the LCR circuit, by phi. Now we can resolve this voltage into two components, one which would be V cos phi and the other which would be V sin phi. So this will be V sin phi and this is V cos phi. Now the product of V cos phi times I, the resistive power, which means the power loss which takes place due to the resistance in the circuit. Whereas V sin phi times I is called the reactive power because this is the power loss in the circuit which takes place due to the reactive components. Since this reactive power is 0, so V sin phi is referred to as the wattless component of the voltage because this is that component of the voltage which doesn't produce any power loss. Now this brings us to the important question that we raised at the beginning of the lesson, that if we have only reactive components in the circuit and if any instantaneous reactive power taken from the supply is returned in the next half of the cycle, then do we have to pay for them? Now if you recall, these components do absorb instantaneous power in one half of each cycle before returning it to the supply in the other half. This storing and returning of power is measured in bars, which is volt ampere reactive, and is actually metered and charged for by the electricity companies, though it is at a reduced rate. Now, if you have a large motor, which means if the value of inductance is large, then these losses are not small. So it is common to correct the power factor to 1. Power factor of 1 would mean cos phi equal to 0. This is the current and this is the voltage across the inductor. Now, this is done by connecting a large capacitor to the load. Load in our case we've assumed is a large motor, which means it has a large value of inductance L, so that the phase of VC is opposite to that of L and it effectively cancels out the VARs. So what we are doing is we are bringing the power factor close to 1, which means we are aiming for phi equal to 0. Now this power factor correction is fairly common in the industry to avoid being charged for these, for the reactive power. To test your understanding, try these questions and the answers are given a short while later. Average power is V RMS, I RMS, cos phi. Wattless component of voltage is V sin phi. Power absorbed by L or C is 0. Power absorbed by R is V RMS times I RMS, which can be written as I RMS square times R. Power factor at resonance phi is 0. So cos phi is 1. If you've got all the answers right, don't forget to write your name in the box below. And of course, give yourself a pat on your back. In case you haven't got them right, don't bother. Go back and listen to the lesson once again and try these questions.